Enemies, because enemies are necessary. Enemies are necessary. In the journey to your destiny, you need enemies. So my message is, you need enemies in the journey to your destiny. You need enemies to the journey of your destiny. God has a destiny for your life. And I want to say this. Some of the things that the Lord desires to establish your life, to do in your life, they will never be accomplished without enemies. So enemies are assets. Enemies are necessary. Enemies are very important in the journey to your destiny. You cannot live without enemies. I know most of you, you don't like enemies. You hate enemies because of the trouble they have been causing you. But today I want you to teach you. May the Lord give you a different perspective concerning the enemies that you have. May the Lord give you a different revelation about the enemies that you are passing through, that are opposing you. Those enemies that are against your life. I want to say this, that enemies are necessary. You cannot live in this world without enemies. You need enemies because enemies have got a part in your life. They have got a responsibility in your life to do. So enemies are necessary. Enemies are necessary. You need enemies in your life. So enemies are blessings. I know we hate enemies, but there's a reason why God has allowed enemies in our lives. There's a reason why God has allowed such opposition happening in your life. God has a reason why he has allowed such opposition in your life. So enemies are necessary. Enemies are necessary. Enemies are part in the journey of your destiny. Now, I will begin by saying this, that most of us, we don't like enemies. Most of us, we don't like enemies. We don't want to live with enemies. We hate enemies. We don't want to hear about enemies. Hatutaki kuhusu maadui. We don't want to hear about enemies. But I'm here to tell you this, that enemies are a blessings. God will use the enemies you have to lead you and to guide you to the throne where God wants you and desires you. So God has a purpose why he has allowed enemies in your life. There's a reason why in your walk, in the salvation, in the promises that God has given you, there's a reason why God has given you and he has enabled enemies to go after you. So enemies are necessary. So we don't like enemies. In fact, enemies, they make life interesting. Without enemies, life cannot be interesting. So some part of our lives, enemies have got a responsibility to make our life interesting. So enemies make life interesting. Enemies make life interesting. Hallelujah. And enemies also will make our life meaningful. Some of us, we cannot enjoy this life without enemies. So enemies are ordained by God. God will allow enemies in the journey of your life. God will allow enemies. God will allow enemies for a reason. They are there to help you and to guide you towards your destiny. So it is not by bad luck that you have enemies in your life. But I'm here to tell you that enemies are there for a reason. Enemies are there for a purpose. And God has allowed those enemies so that they can escort you to your destiny. I'm repeating it again. God will use the enemies of your life. God will use the enemies of your blessings. God will use the enemies of your breakthrough to lead you, to escort you to your blessing. So you need to be encouraged that the enemy cannot do anything against the will of God in your life. They will escort you to where God wants you to be. Hallelujah. So, you know, most of us, we have reached where we are today because of enemies. We are in the levels we are today because of what the enemies have done in our lives. I am a product of the work of the enemies. If it were not for the enemies in my life today, probably I would not be preaching this gospel. So I appreciate so much the enemies that God allowed in my life through this many years when I knew the Lord. I thank God for the enemies that the Lord allowed in my life, because I'm a product of the enemies I have come through in life. I am a product of the suffering, of the trouble and the hardship that the enemies have brought in my life. So I am the way I am today because the enemy had part in it. Hallelujah. So most of us, we are where we are today because of what the enemy have done in our lives. We are what we are today because of what the enemies have been doing in our life. If it were not for the enemies in our lives, then we would not be here today. The levels we are experiencing in our lives, it is because of the enemies that have pushed us to the blessing. The enemies have pushed us to our breakthroughs. The enemies have pushed us to pray and to seek the face of God. The enemies have made us to realize the potential in us. The enemies have made us to believe God in another dimension. So the enemies have been allowed by God for a reason. And those enemies, they cannot stop us. I am here to declare to you that the enemy can stop you from your destiny. Even though God has allowed enemies in your life, but enemies were not ordained. Enemies were not allowed by God to stop you. No enemy can stop you. I am here to declare to you, no enemy can stop you. It was not the intention of God. God never allowed enemies so that they could stop us. Oh, enemies are not meant to stop us, but the enemies are meant to promote us. I am coming to you this evening with a word of an encouragement to you, that your enemy will encourage you, that your enemy will promote you, that your enemy will fulfill the will of God in your life, that your enemy cannot stop you from where God has desired you. Your enemy cannot stop you from your blessing. Your enemy cannot stop you from your prosperity. Your enemy cannot stop you from your peace. So whenever you see an enemy in your life, he doesn't come to stop you. He comes to promote you. I am here to declare to you, wherever you are watching me, I am here to encourage you that God is about to rise you up. God is about to use your enemy to lift you and to encourage you. A promotion is coming through your enemy. A promotion is coming through your enemy. Oh, hallelujah. So the enemies were not meant to stop you. Nobody can stop you. I declare as a servant of God that your enemy cannot stop you. My God, what God has planned in your life, the enemy will come to escort you to your blessing. The enemies will come to promote you. The enemy will not destroy you. I am here to declare to you, the enemy can't do anything to your life. Hallelujah. So God has allowed enemies, because enemies will escort you to your destiny. There are things in your life that God will only accomplish through enemies. I'm repeating it again. There are things, there are levels in your life. You can't reach those levels unless God uses an enemy. I want to say this. There are things in your life. God will not use friends. There are levels in your life. There are dimensions that God wants to take you. He will not use friends, but instead he will use enemies. So I want to decree and declare to you that enemies are servants of God. Oh, I want to say this, that the enemies are servants of God. There are levels, there are revelations in the word of God. There are dimensions in ministry you cannot reach without enemies. It is good you have friends. God bless you for those friends that are loyal. But I'm here to tell you, apart from the friends you have, you need enemies. I know you hate those enemies, but I'm here to tell you, enemies are there for a reason. Enemies are there for a reason. Enemies are there for a reason. Calabra di calabo shakata. In the name of Jesus. Oh, enemies are there for a reason. They do not come to destroy you, but enemy come to promote you. Whenever you see enemies monitoring you, enemies are following you, it is because there is somewhere you are going. It is because God is taking you somewhere. Hallelujah. Oh, sababu kwa nini adui anakufuatilizia? Ha, ni kwa sababu anajua kuna kitu ambacho kinaenda kutendeka. There is something that God is about to do in your life, and the enemy knows he can't stop you. I am here to decree and to declare. I am here to prophesy as a servant of God. No enemy over your family will ever stop you, my God. No enemy at your workplace will stop you. No enemy, my God. God, my Father, God can never allow that enemy to destroy what he has purposed in your life. So nobody can stop you from that breakthrough. No enemy was ever ordained to stop you. You are unstoppable. 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 Nobody. Nobody can stop you. Nobody can stop you. Nobody can stop you. They cannot stop you from the blessings of God. They cannot stop that prophecy that was spoken in your life. They cannot stop you from the promise that God gave you. I am here to declare to you that enemies are necessary. Enemies are necessary. Enemies are important. My God. Enemies are assets. Maadui ni rasilimali, my God. When you have enemies there, then you have a sense. They are not liabilities. And God will use enemies to propel you to your destiny. God will use your enemy to take you to greater levels in life. My God, my God. Let us read in the Bible. 1 Corinthians chapter 16 and verse 9. 1 Corinthians chapter 16 and verse 1. 1 Corinthians chapter 16 and verse 9. And verse 9. The Bible says, "For a great door and effectually is open unto me, and there are many adversary." Kiswahili inasema, kwa maana nimefunguliwa mlango mkubwa wa kufaa sana na wako wengi wanipingao. So Paul is saying, he's writing to the church of Corinthians. He's telling them that a great door has been opened. So that is a fact. So Paul admits to the church of Corinthians that a great door had been opened for them. that a great door, the Lord had opened a great door for the life of Paul. So Paul is saying, a great door. It was not just a door, but the Bible says a great door. In another translation, the Bible says an effectual door. In other words, it was a door with a blessing. It was a door with a rising, with the power of God. So he's saying this, that a great door has been opened for me. So Paul realizes that there's a door that the Lord has opened. There was a door, he's saying, a great door. It is not a door. I am here to declare to you that the Lord has opened a great door in your life. It doesn't matter how many doors the enemy has shut, but the Lord is opening a great door for you. So Paul says, a great door has been opened. A great door has been opened. I decree and I declare to you that this year, even if we have passed through the hardship of life, through the corona pandemic, but I decree unto you that a great door will be opened to you. A great door will open for you. A great door will open for you. I decree and I declare a great door. So Paul says, a great door has been opened to me. So he thanks and appreciates God for the great door that has been opened. Listen to what he's saying. For a great door and effectual has been opened unto me. So Paul realizes he was not the one who had opened the door, but there was someone who had opened the door. And that person who had opened the door, was God. So God had opened a door for Paul. For a great door was opened unto me. I want to declare this. If God has opened a door for you, no man can shut her. No witch can ever shut that door. If God has opened a door of blessing, there is nobody who can refuse that. He's saying that a great door has been opened for me. My God. It was God who opened that door. I want to say this. It is not your uncle. It is not your aunt. It is not your teachers. It is the great door that the Lord has opened. I see God opening doors for your life. Because when he opens, nobody can shut that door. When he shuts the door in your life, nobody can open it. So Paul says, a great door has been opened for me. Now, listen to what he's saying. For a great door and effectually is opened unto me, and there are many adversaries. Now, Paul is speaking about, on the other side, he's speaking about a great door, an effectual door. But he's saying, what accompanies that great door is great. He's saying there are many adversaries. Anasema mlango mkubwa unaofaa umefunguliwa, lakini maadui ni wengi. How is it possible that when God has opened a door for you, that the enemies also are present? So Paul says, a great door has been opened for me, but I realize also there are many adversaries, there are many enemies. My God, I want to say to you, the fact that God has opened a door, it cannot prevent the enemies from pursuing you. It is through God has opened a door, but with the door, enemies will come. So Paul says, a great door, an effectual door has been opened to me, but there are many enemies that are surrounding me. I want to encourage somebody. Regardless of the enemies that are surrounding you, regardless of the enemies that are standing in your doors, Paul saw a great door that the Lord had opened, but also he was seeing great enemies, many enemies. Why did God open a door and he allowed many adversaries, many enemies? Why? It is because the enemy could not stop Paul. The enemy cannot stop you. My God, it is true God has opened a door, but the enemy cannot do anything. The enemy cannot do anything. The enemy can't do anything. And that's why Paul town was having a great door, but at the same time, there were many enemies. Do not be discouraged by the many enemies you have. Do not be discouraged because of what the enemies are doing. Do not be discouraged because of what the enemies are saying. I want to say this. Paul says a great door has been opened, but there are many enemies that are surrounding me. Oh my God. Those enemies are there to promote you. Those enemies cannot stop you. God will not allow enemies to stop you. They cannot stop you unless you allow them to stop you. I'm repeating this again. The enemy cannot stop you unless you allow them to stop you. My God. So usijali, unapoona maadui yamekuzunguka. Paulo aliona mlango mkubwa ambao Mungu alifungua na kaona maadui wengi wamemzunguka. I thank God for the enemies because those enemies can't stop me. For those enemies cannot prevent me from reaching my blessings. My God. Oh, Paul says a great door has been open for me, but when I look, I see enemies. My God. The reason why the enemies are after you, it is because they have seen a door. My God, you know, the enemies in the life of Paul were there because of the great door. The reason why the enemy is after your life, it is because of what you carry. It is because of the destiny that God has planned you. My God, the enemies are against your life because of the assignment that God has given you. The reason why people rise against you, the reason why people are opposing you, it is because of the power you carry. It is because of the grace you carry. It is because of the anointing you carry. And that's why the enemies are after you. They have seen a door in your life. So the presence of enemies, it is the presence of a door. Unapoona mlango ulioko, unapoona maadui, elewa kuna mlango. So stop complaining, stop crying, stop seeking for pity. When you see enemies, know that there's a door they have seen. I am here to prophesy to you. I am here to encourage you. A great door is open. That's why the enemies have been against your life. That's why the witch doctors have been rising against you. That's why people have been criticizing you. That's why people have been doing all things, all bad things. It is because of the door. It is because for the opportunity and the breakthrough that God is about to release in your life. I see a door opening for your life. So enemies cannot stop you. Enemies cannot stop you. They can't stop you. So Paul says, great door has been opened, but there are many adversaries. My God, you need enemies. My God, you need enemies. My God, I want to say to you this. To be successful, you need friends. To be successful, you need friends. And to be very successful, you need enemies. Listen to me. In order for you to succeed, if you need success, you need friends. But if you need so much success, you need enemies. So to be successful, you need friends. But to be very successful, you need enemies. I'm repeating it again. To be successful, you need friends. But to be very, very successful, you need enemies. Oh, they are there. There are levels of success you can't reach by friends. There are levels of success. Friends will not take you there. It is only the enemies can take you to that very success. My God, their level in life, their level dimensions in your life, you will not reach by friends. I don't say that the friends are bad. Friends are good, but there are things in your life God will not establish them. God will not accomplish them through friends. You need enemies, my God. My God, to be successful, you need friends. But to be very successful, successful, you need enemies, my God. And that's why when you succeed so much, enemies will be against you. When you read the life of Isaac, when he grew wealthy, when he was successful in the land, the Bible says that they rose against him. They envied him. Why? They were jealousy because he was very successful. Unapoona watu wanakuchukia kupita kiasi ni kwa sababu mafanikio yako ni yako juu yako kupita kiasi. Hallelujah. Kuna mafanikio unahitaji marafiki, lakini kuna kufanikiwa kwingine watakao kusindikiza ni maadui zako. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I hope you have had that point. There are levels of success. You need enemies. Karado sekete. I am here also to say this. You need people who will mock you. You need enemies who will mock you. You need people who will mock you so that you can be courageous. Hallelujah. You need people, my Father, my God. You need people who will mock you so that you can turn to God. When they mock you, it will force you to seek God. God will allow enemies in your life so that they may mock you, so that you may seek God. My God, there are levels of seeking God. It can only happen when you have an enemy who is pursuing your family, who is pursuing your marriage, who is pursuing your worker, who is pursuing your ministry. Oh my God, God is about to use your enemies. You need people who will intimidate you. You need enemies who will intimidate you so that you may be courageous. My God, there are levels of courage. There are levels of confidence in your life. You will never reach them until God has allowed enemies to intimidate you. So do not cry. Do not complain, my God. God is about to raise up in you courage and confidence. You need people to intimidate you. Oh my God. When you are intimidated through your enemies, then God will give you courage. God, a courage will be birthed in you. Mungu atainua ujasiri ndani yako. Niposa unatishiwa, maadui wanakutishia ili ukawe ngangari. My God. So you need people to intimidate you so that those people can help you to develop courage. Ndio lazima unatishiwa ili uwe ngangari. My God. So enemies are very important. Enemies, they are vessels of God. Enemies, they are servants of God. And God uses enemies to propel us to our blessing. God uses enemy to propel us to our breakthrough. My God, my God, my God. Who is an enemy? Let me define who an enemy is. An enemy, according to the dictionary, he is a person who hates or opposes another person and tries to harm or stop them from doing something. So an enemy is a person, is a thing that hates you, that opposes you, so that or tries to stop you from doing or achieving something in your life. An enemy is anybody or a thing that is trying to hurt you, number one. Number two, it tries to oppose you, number two. Number three, it tries to stop you so that you may not do something or achieve something in life. So the work of the enemies is to oppose you. The work of an enemy is to hurt you. It is to try to stop you, my God. So an enemy is anybody who is trying to stop you. An enemy is anybody or anything that tries to oppose your movement, that tries to oppose your progress. That is an enemy. So anything that opposes your life, anything that opposes your blessing, anything that opposes your prosperity, it is an enemy. So enemies, they come to try to stop you. But I've told you before, before that no enemy can ever stop you from reaching your destiny. Enemies cannot stop you. Enemies cannot stop you. They can't stop you. I am here to declare, enemies cannot stop you. Enemies have been released so that they can promote you. So whenever you see an enemy, know that there is a promotion coming. So enemies, they come to promote. Enemies come to promote. So I want to say this, that you need an enemy. And you know, Jesus needed enemies for him to be crucified at the cross. Jesus needed enemies for him to be crucified on the cross. We are, you know, the salvation we have is a product, my God, is a product and the work of enemies. If it were not for the enemies of Jesus, Jesus would not have died on the cross. The reason why Jesus was crucified, it is because he had enemies. So if Jesus required enemies, it's Jesus needed enemies to establish and to accomplish his assignment. I am here to tell you also, you cannot avoid enemies. Jesus needed enemies for him to go to the cross. So also you need enemies. So it was because of the enemies that Jesus was crucified. Kama si maadui, Yesu asinge sulubiwa. Kwa hivyo Yesu alikuja kutimiza kusudi lake katika ulimwengu huu, lakini asinge timiza pasipo maadui. So we see enemies were part of the plan and the purpose of the destiny of Jesus. They were in that purpose. Enemies were part of the purpose and the destiny of Jesus. So it was through the enemies that Jesus was crucified. In other words, I want to say this. Jesus needed Judas for him to be betrayed. Yesu alitadi Yuda ili amsaliti. My God. Yesu alitadi Yuda ili asalitiwe. I want to say this. It is enemies that will betray you. I know some of you, people who you trusted have betrayed you. And you know one thing about enemies. You realize this, that enemies are people who are so close to you. Most of us, you will agree with me, that enemies are not far. Maadui hawakaagi mbali. Enemies are closer to you. They are people who are very close to you. They are entities that are closer to you. Enemies are things, are people who are very close to you. People you cannot think of. They are your enemies. They are your enemies. So don't look to the enemies from afar. No, 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 no. Enemies are things or people that are close to you. Enemies are there. They have been monitoring you. They have been looking every step you've been making. They have been listening to your confession. Enemies have been following you up. Enemies have been following you up. Enemies have been following all through. So enemies, you realize that they are very close to you. Hallelujah. You'll be surprised. Some of the persecution you are passing right now, it has been caused by people who are very close to you. People that you trust. People that you eat with them. People that you laugh with them. People who you pray with. Those people, they can be used as enemies. They will never identify themselves and tell you, my brother, I'm your enemy. No. Enemies are not from far. They are closer than you think. Wako karibu na wewe. Samson did not realize that the enemy was so close to him. Delilah was so close to him. He did not realize that Delilah was so close. Aliyemwangusha Samson hakuwa mwanamke wa sokoni. Hakuwa mwanamke wa mbali, alikuwa ni mwanamke ambaye alikuwa karibu. Alikuwa karibu na nani? Alikuwa karibu na Samson. Delilah was so close. so close to something. I am telling you, you can be laughing with your enemy without knowing. You can be eating with your enemy without knowing. Do not be surprised, because you can imagine Jesus was eating with his disciple together with Judas on the same table. And immediately after the dinner, Judas went to the authorities and betrayed Jesus and gave Jesus to the authorities. Imagine, wametoka kula, wametoka kufurahia, wametoka mahepi, and the next thing, amesulubiwa. Oh, hallelujah. The next thing amefanya nini? Amesulubiwa. So don't be surprised. Do not be surprised. Hallelujah. So these enemies were so close. So close. So close to Jesus. So Judas decided to betray Jesus. I want to say this. You are not the first one to be betrayed. You are not the first one. Jesus was betrayed. Jesus was betrayed. Jesus was betrayed. You are not the first one. Usishangae watu wakikusaliti. Wewe si wa kwanza. Yesu alisalitiwa na marafiki zake. Watu ambao alikula nao kila siku. Watu ambao aliwaita. Watu ambao aliwapatia nguvu. Watu ambao aliwapatia upako ndio waliomgeuka. So Jesus needed enemies, not friends. Yesu hakuhitaji marafiki, maana marafiki wasinge kubali Yesu asulubiwe. Kwa hivyo kuna vitu katika maisha yako, marafiki hawezi kukusaidia. There are things in your life, friends will not help you. You need enemies. I'm repeating it again. There are things in your life. There are things in your life that are enemies. That enemies will help you. But their friends will not help you. Are you together with him? Umenielewa? Kuna levels katika maisha yako. Huwezi kufika pasipo maadui. Ni maadui peke yake utakao kusaidia. Ha. Let us read the Bible. In Psalms chapter 23. Psalms chapter 23. Verse 5. Psalms. Chapter 23 and verse 5. Verse 5. Verse 5. The Bible says, thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You prepare a table before the presence of my enemies. Sikiza hiyo. Anaanda meza machoni pa watesi. This is God preparing a table. A table of celebration. A table of rejoicing. Thou prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemy. Kwa hivyo, enemies. God knows that the enemies cannot stop you. And that's why he can afford to prepare a table before your enemies. God is not intimidated by your enemies. Mungu atishiwi na hao adui wako wanaopeleka umbea. Mungu atishiwi na hao. Biblia inasema anaandaa meza mbele ya watesi wako. He prepares a table in the presence of your enemies. So, sikiza, I want to say this. That the greater the enemies, the greater the table. The more you see the enemies are, know that your breakthrough is great. So he prepares a table before your enemies. In other words, when you see God preparing a table for you, realize that there is celebration. My God, when you see God preparing a table, when you see there are many enemies, know that there's a table that the Lord has prepared for you. Ukiona maadui, elewa, kuna meza inayoandaliwa. I'm here to declare to you that the Lord is preparing a table for you. And God will not give that responsibility to the angels to prepare a table for you. The Bible says that he prepares a table for you in the presence of your enemy. He knows that the enemies can't do anything. And that's why he prepares your table in their presence. And that's why I told you in the beginning, the enemies cannot stop you. They cannot stop your celebration. They cannot stop your breakthrough. They cannot. They can't. They can't. He prepares a table before your enemies. So the enemies cannot do anything. They cannot stop you, but they can promote you. The Bible says he prepares a table before his enemies. So if you're seeing enemies in your life, realize there's a table that the Lord is preparing. Hallelujah. Kuna meza iliyoandaliwa mama. Kuna meza iliyoandaliwa kijana, wewe mse. There is a table that the Lord has prepared for you. And that's why the enemies are present. Whenever you see enemies in your life, notice this, that there's a table that the Lord is preparing. Thank God, because God is preparing something special for you. And the enemy cannot stop it. Maadui hawatazuia. Kama watakula na macho wacha wakule. Lakini Mungu anaandaa meza. And you know, when he prepares a table, it is for you. The Bible says, he prepares a table for me. He prepares a table for me in the presence of my enemies. So the reason why God is preparing that table, it is not for anybody. The table is not for the enemies. It is for you. Ha. Mungu anaandaa meza kwa ajili yako. Lakini anasema katikati ya maadui zako. So God is preparing, my God. God is preparing a table in the midst of your enemies. He's preparing a table in the midst of your enemies. So the enemy cannot stop you, my God. The greater your enemies, the greater your table. The greater your enemies, the greater your breakthrough. Ukiona maadui wako wamekuwa wengi, elewa mujiza wako ni mkubwa. Oh my God. The greater the enemies, the greater the miracle. The greater the enemies, the greater the testimony. I see your testimony is greater, because the enemies that are following you are many. He prepares a table before in the presence of my enemies. I want to say this. Enemies cannot stop you. And that's why God prepares a table in the presence of your enemies. In other words, when God is about to do great thing in your life, he doesn't do it in private. He does it in public. And that's why he says he prepares a table in the presence of my enemies. Nataka kusema hivi, Mungu anapokuandalia meza, anapoandaa baraka zako, anapoenda kuleta ushuhuda, hatafanya kwa siri, ataonyesha wazi, nipoza ushuhuda ukajulikane, anaandaa meza machoni pa watesi wako. He is creating a table in the presence of your enemy, in the presence of your enemy. So your table is being prepared, not privately, but publicly. Your testimony, I want to declare to you, your testimony will be public. Your testimony will be public. Oh, you can write this. My testimony will be public. My miracle will be public. You can write this. My miracle will be public. My God, it will not be in private. The Bible says he prepares a table before in the midst of my enemies. So what God is about to do, my God, you've been crying, you've been suffering in private, but God is about to release a breakthrough publicly. Oh my God, write this, my God, write this, write this, my testimony will be public. My miracle will be public. My God, my God, he prepares a table before the presence of my enemies. Ananda meza. katikati ya maadui zangu. I want to declare this, you've been rejected in private, but God is about to release, you will be accepted in public. My God, my God, my God. Oh, they made you cry in private, but you are just about to laugh in public. My God, my God. Lebra da kasekete. Ah, your testimony will be public. Your testimony will be public. Your miracle will be public. Your breakthrough will be public. My God, God will prepare it in the presence of your enemies. In the presence of your enemy. The enemy can't stop you. The enemy cannot stop your marriage. The enemy cannot stop your business. Oh my God. Ulisota sana ukangangana katika siri, lakini Mungu anaenda kunyanyua katika wazi, katika umati. Your blessing will be public. My God, my God. You struggled for many years, but your breakthrough is about to be public. Your blessing is about to be public. Your prosperity is about to be public. I'm here to declare as a servant of God, your testimony will be public. My God, I refuse. My God, I want it to be public. Nataka iwe wazi, watu wajue. Hakuna kuficha. My God, mama umelia sana, wamekusema vibaya kwa muda mrefu. Wacha unapobarikiwa watu wajue umebarikiwa. They have said, they have criticized you, they have planned, they have put many words on you, but you have been waiting on God. Your time to be exposed in public has come. Your time of manifestation, because when God manifests your glory, when God manifests your testimony, it will be public. Oh, God is about to manifest in your life. My God, God is about to manifest in your life. God is about to manifest in your life. God is about to make your testimony public. Your testimony shall be breaking news. Your testimony, your miracle shall be your breaking news. Oh, kuna mambo Mungu atafanya. Yatawacha watu midomo wazi. Yatawacha watu wakishangaa. Maana anaandaa meza machoni pa watesi wako. Oh, do not be discouraged because of the criticizing. Because what they say about you, the bad things they have said about your family, the bad things they have said about your marriage, the bad things they have said about your ministry, do not be discouraged. My God, God is about to shame them in public. And God is about to declare your testimony. God is about to declare your miracle. God is about to declare your breakthrough in the public. My God, it is not about a secret place again. It is not about being done secretly. Oh, you know the enemies have been planning your downfall in secret. They have been meeting. They have been discussing you in secret. But God is about to shame them. God is about to expose them in the public. I pray for you. Every enemy that has been planning your downfall during the night, that they have been planning your downfall in the secret place, I decree and I declare, let them be exposed in public. Wamekaa siri, wamekaa sirini, wakikuongea vibaya, wakati huu Mungu anaenda kufunua. Because God is about to show forth his glory in your life, because he's preparing a table in the presence of your enemies. He's preparing a table in the presence of your enemies. God is preparing a table. 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 I'm so excited, my God. I'm so excited. I'm so excited. All the blessings in your life you cannot reach unless you have an enemy. So I want to declare to you, enemies are very important. From today, start rejoicing. Start thanking God for the many enemies that have been pursuing your life. Tell God thank you because you are preparing a table. Thank you for those enemies who have criticized me. Thank you for those enemies who are against me. Thank you because they are about to promote me. Oh, they are about to escort me to my blessings. Thank God for your blessings. Thank God for your enemies. And that's why the Bible says in Luke 6:27, that love your enemies. Why does God tell you to love your enemy? Luke 6:27. It is because he knows there's nothing that the enemy can do to stop your blessing. There's nothing the enemy can do to stop you from your destiny. If God has decided to bless you, he will bless you. Kama Mungu ameamua kukuinua, haijalishi kuzimu, mababu na altars, those evil foundations in your life that have been against you, a season of rising has come. The enemy cannot stop you. Maadui hawakuzui. They cannot stop you. They cannot stop you. They cannot stop you. I want to encourage you and tell you the reason why Goliath was raised. It was because of David to rise up. The only reason why Goliath came into the scene, it was not because of the children of Israel. Goliath yakuwa wana wa Israel. Goliath alikuwa ni wanani Daudi. Alikuwa ni kwa ajili ya Daudi. Alikuwa ni kwa ajili ya Daudi. Hallelujah. It was because of David. It was because of David. So there was no reason. So the only way that Goliath was able to release himself before God, the reason why Goliath was allowed by God, it was for David to rise. Na katika maisha yako, kuna Goliath ambao Mungu atawaachilia, atawaruhusu, ili Daudi ndani yako ainuke. Oh my God. The reason why Goliath existed was for David to appear. My God. If you see that Goliath is still standing, know that the David has not arose in you. But the Lord will use the enemy called Goliath for David to arise. God will make you rise up using the Goliath, your enemy. So David was able to be promoted. And that's why for 40 days and night, Israel could not tackle Goliath, because Goliath was for David. There are things you are passing through. It was not meant for your family. It was not meant for your mother. It was not meant for your aunt. It was not meant for your uncle. It was only meant for you. It was only meant for you. It was only meant for you. You hear that? It was only meant for you. So Goliath was there because of David. Until David appeared, Goliath did not disappear. My God. The only way that Goliath can disappear, it is for David to appear. Because when you see, when David came to the scene and tackled Goliath and he killed Goliath, that was the end story of Goliath. We don't hear about Goliath again. When David in your life arise through the enemies that God has allowed, that will be the last time you hear about Goliath. Kwa hivyo baada ya hapo, hautasikia tena kuhusu Goliath. Baada ya Daudi kumwangusha na kumua, Goliath ndio alimalizika. My God, my God. The only way that Goliath can disappear is for David to manifest, is for David to appear. How I pray for you, that the David in you will arise, that the David in you will arise. I pray for you that David will arise in you. 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 I pray for you that Goliath will come down. Every Goliath in your life will come down. When you appear, when you manifest in your life, Goliath has to come down. Goliath wako lazima anguke. Wakati Daudi alitokelezea, ndio ilikuwa story ya Goliath. There are things happening in your marriage. There are things happening in your clan, in your family, and nobody can tackle them except you. There are things that are happening. The enemy has been messing up with your family. Until you arise, until the David in you arise through the enemies, because enemies will steer you up. They will come, watakuja wakuchokoze. Oh, kuna level nyingine ya kufika kuchoka, hawezi kuchoka kama maadui hawaja kusumbua. You need to reach a place you say, enough is enough, I am tired. And that level you will only reach when the enemy have pursued you, when the enemy have pushed you to the wall, when the enemy have pushed you to the box. That is when you say, enough is enough. I want God to see God in my life. So enemies are very important. Enemies are very important. Enemies are very important. Enemies are very important. God will use your enemies. Kalabra liga dabosha. My God. So David required Goliath. Wacha kulalamika. Oh, Goliath, Goliath, yuko ili Daudi anyanyuke. My God, my Father, I've realized there are things even if I wished that other people could pass, it was not meant for them. It was for me, Samora. Sia mtu mwingine, sikiza, huyo ni Goliath wangu. Goliath wangu, mipaka Daudi ndani yangu ainuke. Akiendelea kwa siku 40 usiku na mchana, kutukana jeshi la Mungu, ni kwa sababu Daudi hajainuka. The reason why God has allowed enemies in your life, he wants your David to arise. He wants your ministry to arise. He wants the potential in you to arise. He wants that power to be manifested. There's so much great power in your life. It will never be released until an enemies make you uncomfortable. Until enemies make you uncomfortable. Until enemies make you suffer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There are levels in life you cannot reach without a Goliath. Thank God for the Goliaths. Thank God for the enemies that have been pursuing you. Oh, I thank God for the enemies that God has used. They have pushed me to trust God. They have pushed me to believe God. They have pushed me to seek God. They have pushed me to prayer. They have pushed me to faster. There are things, there are levels. We cannot learn the levels of fasting unless enemies are pushing us. Wengine hatukujua kufunga kama si maadui kutusukuma, kama si maadui kutuchokoza, ni kwa sababu walituchokoza, ni kwa sababu walitufinya, niposa tukajifundisha kuomba, niposa tukajifundisha kumtafuta Mungu. So enemies are necessary. Enemies were not meant to stop you. They were meant to promote you. They were meant to lift you up. My God. My God, my God. Oh, I see the end of your Goliath, my Father. I see the end of your Goliath because you have gotten a revelation about your enemies. Oh, wachana kukosa usingizi, acha stress kwa sababu wao wamesemaje, wao walisema nini. Oh, that is not your work. That is not your responsibility. Go on. Continue with what God has told you. Because they must be there. You don't need even to pray for them. Oh, God, bring enemies. They will come. They will see that they need to come. So even after this message, do not be surprised when you see enemies arising against you. It is because a table has been prepared. There is a breakthrough coming. And that's why they are rising against you. That's why they are speaking bad about you. Oh, my God. I came to discover this. You know why enemies have been following my life? You know why enemies have been troubling me? Because even though they hate me, but somehow they like me. In fact, my enemies are my fan. And I am telling you, some of your enemy, God will use them to publicize you. Mungu atatumia adui zako wakutangaze. I pray for you that God will use your enemy to declare to you, to declare publicly about you. People have never known you, but through your enemy, people will know you. Very soon, people will start looking for you. I prophesy to you, people will start looking for you because your enemies will promote you. They will promote you publicly. Wataanza kukutangaza. Oh, yale mambo anayosema. Wale mambo anasema kuhuduma yako. Oh my God. When they say, oh, I use or I use the power of the devil to heal the sick or to do miracle, I do not care. Oh my God. Oh, they are just promoting me. I don't need to pay for advertising me. Oh my God. God will use your enemies to advertise you. God will use your enemies to advertise you. Write this down. God will use my enemies to advertise me. Write this down, please. Yoyote anayenisikia, andika hii. Mungu anaenda kunitangaza kupitia maadui zangu. God is about to advertise me through my enemies. God will use enemies to advertise you. Just the same way what God did through Haman. It is Haman who declared and advertised the things that Mordecai was to be done. Ni Hamani aliyetangaza yale ambayo mfalme atamfanyia Mordecai. I am here to declare, write this down, that God will use my enemy to advertise me. God will use my enemies to advertise my ministry. God will use my enemies to advertise my business. God will use my enemies. God will use your enemies to announce your ministry. My God, some of the people, they need to hear your ministry. So do not fear when they say you are a devil worshiper. My God, they are advertising you. You will not pay for that advertisement. People all over Kenya will know you. Because God is using you. God is manifesting his power in your life. The enemy cannot stop you. The enemy cannot stop you. Neither, oh my God, you are there to be blessed. I pray for you. May your enemy start advertising you. Nina kuombea adui waanze kukutangaza. May the enemy begin to advertise you. May your enemy begin to advertise you. May your enemy begin to advertise you. May your enemies begin to advertise you. Oh my God. They will advertise you. People will begin to look for you. I pray before the end of this year, people will be looking for you. They'll be looking for your number. They will be looking for your number. The enemies, my God, will advertise you. La cabra liga bahaso libra doko sekete wamesema. Oh, they've been saying you've been using magic, you've been using witchcraft in your business, in your farm. My God, they don't know there is a Jehovah in heaven who blesses, there is a Jehovah in heaven who prospers. Oh, they are just declaring what God has done. Oh, your enemy will advertise you. The enemy will advertise your business. The enemy will advertise your ministry. The enemy will advertise you, my God. They will advertise your potential. Oh my God. My God, my God. 90%, listen to this. 90% of your achievement are not from your enemies, but they are from your enemies. 90% of your achievement in life, they are because of the enemies were used. Mafanikio makubwa katika maisha yetu sisi ni sababu ya maadui. I know you love those friends, but there are things that your friends won't help you. There are levels, oh my God, there are heights, there are depths in life, in ministry. Friends won't take you there. It is the enemies that can cause you to go the breadth, the height, and the depth. Hear me clearly. Hear me clearly. You know, there are levels in life. There are dimensions in life you can't reach unless God does something in you through your enemies. Now, very fast, the importance of your enemies. The importance of your enemies. The importance of your enemies. Number one, enemies help you to discover your strength. Enemies help you to discover your strength, your potential. The importance of enemies. Number one, enemies help you to discover your strength. My God. So when enemies are around you, they will help you to discover the potential. They will help you to discover your strength. Oh my God. Your enemies will help you to know your strength. Nguvu zako utajua kupitia maadui. So enemies will help you to discover your strength. Enemies will help you to discover your strength. Enemies will help you to discover your potential. You cannot discover your potential and your strength without enemies. It is the enemies that can help you to discover your strength. That is number one. So enemies will help you to discover your strength. Number two, they will help you to stay in balance. Enemies will help you to stay in balance. You need a balance in your life. And it is through the enemy that God will use to make a balance in your life. So God will use enemies to bring a balance. God will use enemies to bring a balance. God will use enemies in your life to bring a balance. Number three, they will help you to stay in cause. Enemies are good because they will help you to stay in cause. Watakusaidia kukaa kwa barabara. Because you can be diverted with many things in this world. But you know, God will use enemies to help you stay in cause. They will help you to stay in the road. Usije ukajisahau. So enemies, God will use enemies to make you stay on course. That is number three. Number four. Enemies will push you closer to God and help you to be dependent on God. When God allows enemies in your life, they are there to push you closer to God. Enemies will push you closer to God. Enemies will push you closer to the presence of God. Enemies will push you closer to God. Enemies will enable you to stay focused, to wait on God, and to depend on God. So number one, we say they will help you discover your strength. Number two, we have said they will help you stay in balance. Number three, we have said they will help you stay in cause. Number four, we have said that they will push you closer. They will push you closer to God, that you may depend on God. So they make you come closer to God. Some of you have been seeking God so hard now. You have been seeking God as never before because of what the enemy has been doing. Thank God for the enemies. They have made you to seek God. They have made you to encounter God in your life. So they come to push you closer to God. And they make you to be dependent on God. Number five. Enemies, they help you to become better. Enemies will help you to become better. Enemies will help you to become better. That is number five. They will help you to become better. That is number five. So, number six, they will help you realize the greatness in you. There's some greatness in your life, in your heart. And it is through the enemy. When the enemy oppresses you, when the enemy pushes you, that is the time you recognize the strength that is in your heart. The strength that is in your heart. The power that is in your heart. So you will get to realize the power within. Number seven, they help you to sharpen your skills. Wanakuja kukunoa. Maadui wanakuja kukunoa. Enemies, they come to sharpen you. They come to make you sharp. They come to sharpen you. They come to sharpen you. And number eight, the last one. Number eight. They help us to pursue our dreams and visions despite them trying to make it hard. Have you gotten that? They help us to pursue our dreams and visions despite the hardship, despite the persecutions that the enemy are causing. But when the enemies are there, they make you not to quit easily. You say, no, I will not quit. I know there's something coming. That's why the enemy is pushing me to the wall. So even though they are pushing you to the wall, even though they are making you suffer, even though they are causing pain, but in another way, they are helping you to pursue, to continue in your dream, in your vision. Don't be discouraged. Pursue your dreams. Pursue your vision through the enemies that are after your life. So they are there to make you and help you to achieve your vision, to achieve your blessings, to achieve your dreams. And I want to finish by saying, if you cannot handle your enemies, you cannot handle your table. If you cannot handle your enemies, you cannot handle your table. If you cannot handle your enemies, you cannot handle your blessing. If you cannot handle your enemies, you cannot handle your breakthrough. If you cannot handle your enemies, you cannot handle your testimony. If you cannot handle your enemies, you cannot handle your breakthrough. So it is very necessary for you to know that the enemies cannot stop you. God is about to use your enemies to bless you, to transform your life. God is about to do greater things in your life through the enemies that are after your life. So I'm here to encourage you that it is not surprising that enemies are after your life. Don't be surprised because you're facing a lot of opposition. Don't be surprised because things are trying to stop you. It is because God is doing something great. It's because God will use those enemies, because those enemies cannot stop you from your blessing. God has to bless you. God has to bless you. God has to transform you through your enemies. The enemies cannot stop you. So I have come today, this evening to you, to tell you that the enemies are a blessing. Change your focus. Change your perspective. Change your attitudes towards your enemies. You need to change your attitude. You need to change your mind towards the enemy that have been causing trouble to your life. Those enemies are there for a reason. They are there for your promotion. Wako hapo akuinue. Wako hapo akufanye utoboe. My God, they can't stop you. God will use them to escort you to your blessing. So may the Lord bless you today, even as you have heard this word, that enemies are important. You need enemies in the journey of your destiny. Kuna vitu katika maisha yako, marafiki hawezi kukufanyia. There are things I have come to discover. There are levels, there are things in my life, in my part, in the journey of my destiny. There are things and there are levels I cannot reach without enemies. I know, I thank God for the many friends God has given me. But I know there are levels. How? There are bridges I cannot cross with friends. It is only the enemies who I can cross with. There are things in your life that friends won't help you. Friends are good, but you need enemies. So thank God, start rejoicing because of your enemies, because they cannot stop you. I have told you this. The presence of an enemy is not the assurance of your downfall. The presence of an enemy is not an assurance that you will fail. Hallelujah. 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 So I know you have heard this word. I know you have understood this word. And your life will never remain the same. I want to pray with you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I declare your blessing to these people. In the name of Jesus, they have heard your word. You have spoken to them. Holy Spirit, bless them. Holy Spirit, transform them. I know those enemies cannot stop them. Nothing can ever stop them to their destiny. I pray, may you strengthen them. May you help them to reach their destiny. May you use those enemies to be a blessing to them. May you use those enemies to declare, to advertise them, to advertise their ministry, to advertise their potential. My Father and my God, I speak your blessing to their life. I speak your mercy and grace to their life. Use them for your glory. Transform them, Lord. I speak a blessing to everybody who has been watching. May the blessings of God reach upon you. And may the Lord take you to greater heights. I decree and I declare to you that the Lord is preparing a table in the presence of your enemy. May the Lord make you rejoice. Very soon, may the Lord make you rejoice. In the name of Jesus, may the Lord make you rejoice. 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 In the name of Jesus, may the Lord prepare a table. I speak greater testimony. I speak greater miracles. I speak greater testimonies. I speak greater miracles. I speak greater breakthrough in your life. Because God will use your enemies to be a blessing. Thank you, Father. May the blessings of God reach you wherever you are. In the name of Jesus, I pray and believe. Amen. If you have not given your life to Christ, this is the opportunity where you can give your life to Christ. You can tell Jesus today, I come to you. I'm a sinner. I need you, Holy Spirit. I know God has got something for you today. Say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I come before you. I'm a sinner. I need you. Today, I give you my life. I give you my heart. I will live for you. I will serve you the rest of my life. I surrender to you, Holy Spirit, today. Help me, my Father. May the blessings of God come upon my life. From today, I will serve you. I will walk in your will. In the name of Jesus, I pray and believe. Amen. May the Lord bless you wherever you are. Thank you for all of those who have been watching me, who have been following me up. You've been a blessing to me. You've been a blessing to my ministry. Whenever I come, you can hear this word. It is my pleasure to share this word of God. It is my prayer that God will turn around your life, that your life will never remain the same. After hearing such words, may the Lord encourage you and lift you. May the Lord heal you. If you are sick in your body, receive the healing of God. May the Lord give you peace to your mind. May God give you to relax in your life. May the blessing of God come and overtake you. Oh, God bless you so much. You can subscribe to my videos at the YouTube at Pastor Samora Kitengi. That is my YouTube channel. Subscribe, please. Like it, please. You can download the messages. You can watch. You can share to the friends, and the Lord will bless you. My name is Pastor Samora Kitengi from Abundant Life Center, Taveta, Kenya. And I am so blessed to have you. There are so many. God bless you. I cannot mention you all. You are so many. But may the blessings of God come upon all of you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord protect you. May the blessings of God come and overtake you. And your life will never remain the same. You are just about to break through. For your rising has come. Your breakthrough has come. May the Lord bless you. Shalom. I love you. In Jesus' name I pray. Until we meet then, I'm coming back on Sunday. Sunday at 10:30, I'm coming with another message that God has given me for you to be encouraged and to be blessed. God bless you. Shalom.